This video was brought to you by the ILC. Hello there once again. Welcome back. This is episode 39. In this episode, we're going to do another application of a polynomial equation. We're going to expand on what we did in the previous episode just a little bit. Let's get started. In this problem, we have a livestock pen to be built on the bank of a river with three sides, x, y, and another side that is also x. The fourth side will not be there because the river makes up the fourth side. Now, between the three sides that we have, we will have 50 yards of fencing. Part A of the question is to find a polynomial equation for the area of the pen. Let's go ahead and try to write some sort of expression for area. Well, area of this rectangle shape is length times width. The length of the rectangle is y, and the width of the rectangle is x. So we can say that the area of the rectangle is y times x. Just like the last problem, we have two letters here, and it's better if we try to write the polynomial equation with only one letter. So our first step, as before, is to replace one of the letters. Now, because both of the letters are first power, it doesn't matter too much which one we try to replace. But I'm going to go ahead and replace y, and that choice is pretty much arbitrary. So we're going to choose y. In order to replace one of the letters, we're going to have to write a second equation. Let's use the other piece of information we know, that it has 50 yards of fencing. So we have 50 equals something. Now our fencing has 1y and 2x's. One on the left, one on the right. So that our second step is to solve the equation we just wrote for y. We'll rewrite the equation, 50 equals y plus 2x. In order to get y by itself, we will need to subtract the 2x to the other side. So on the left, we will have 50 minus 2x equals just y, because the 2x and the minus 2x cancel out. For our third step, we will replace y with the expression we just found. That is the 50 minus 2x. We'll take the 50 minus 2x and replace the y with it, so that our area is now 50 minus 2x in parentheses times x. We can simplify that a little bit by taking x times both terms of the binomial. We'll have area equals 50 times x, or 50x. Minus 2x times x, which is 2x squared. This will be our polynomial that represents the area. That's the end of part A. So here are some other questions we could answer. For part B, it says to find the length and the width that give you the maximum possible area. And generally, when you find the maximum, what you're really looking for is the vertex, because that's the maximum of a second power equation. So to find the vertex, we'll have to say x is equal to negative b over 2a. Recall that b is the number next to x, and a is the number next to x squared. So our x will equal negative 50 divided by 2 times negative 2. If we do the operations, we'll have negative 50 divided by negative 4, and if you divide those, you'll get 12.5. Now, this is the x value, or the width. If you would like to get the length also, we'll need to use this equation, that y equals 50 minus 2x, in order to get the length, which is y. So we'll say y equals 50 minus 2x. Now, we've already found x. It's 12.5. So we'll say 50 minus 2 times 12.5. This gives us 50 minus 25. And 50 minus 25 is 25. This is our length. So we have a width of 12.5 and a length of 25, and that's what's going to give us the maximum possible area. Now let's have a look at part C also. Part C says to find the value of the maximum area. So recall that area equals length times width. The length is 25 times the width, which is 12.5. If you multiply these together, you should get 312.5 for our area. So, this is a good example of a problem you might be expected to solve with a second power polynomial. Not only writing the second power polynomial in terms of one variable, but also finding the maximum and finding the dimensions of the shape that give it the maximum. Thanks for watching. We'll see you again next episode.